We just looked at some changes in the core network architecture of 5G. Let's look at the second part next. That is 5G in our bearer network, or we call it the changes in the backhaul network. Finally, we will look at the wireless side on the bearer network, or we say on the backhaul network, we see a concept called 5G backhaul layer 3 to the edge. Of course, this is relative to 4G because when we are in our bearer network or called backhaul network, we also used to be layered and graded. What we usually see is from access, the entire bearer network is divided into access ring, convergence ring and core ring. But when we were in 4G, it didn't reach the edge. For example, we carry in the 4G era, or we call it the backhaul network. We usually call it the backhaul network. It is also layered and graded. For example, we have a base station here. Of course, there will be multiple base stations. This base station, Sampan, will first access an access ring. Above it will be our convergence ring. The top one is our core ring. There are some of our devices on this ring. There will be some of our devices on this ring. But we used to be in the 4G era when accessing the ring. We often use the second layer. There is no layer 3 function then. At this time, if you want to achieve interstation interconnection, for example, I have another station here. You want to achieve this kind of interstation interconnection, then you have to go up to layer 3 to achieve. This data can only be achieved through layer 3 because this access ring only has layer 2 functions. It does not have layer 3 functions. So in this case, we will find that this path is a bit roundabout. Especially in some low latency scenarios, this transmission delay will seem a bit long. So in 5G, we proposed a concept to achieve layer 3 to the edge. For example, in the 4G era, then our access ring and convergence ring, it has implemented layer 3 on convergence, or maybe I don't have convergence. It is also possible to put convergence and core together. Then I want to achieve this kind of interstation interaction. Then it must go through layer 3 devices to go around. It cannot be directly implemented on the access ring. It has to go around. The problem this brings is the delay will be relatively large in the future. We will, in the 5G network, will move the layer 3 function down. We will implement the layer 3 function on the access ring. These access ring devices, they all need to have layer 3 capabilities. Then in this way, we implement these interstation when forwarding data traffic. It can be directly implemented on the access ring device. For example, these two stations, of course, this is a NR5G station. This is another NR5G station. They can directly communicate through this access ring device to achieve layer 3 communication. Of course, for the base station equipment itself, implementation is also relatively easy, right? I only need to add a route to achieve it. This is in the bearer network, or in our backhaul network, we will move the layer 3 function down to the access side. The benefit of this is, first of all, our delay is reduced. Another point is that we don't need to this interstation data transmission. It does not need to occupy a lot of convergence ring or core ring traffic. It is consumed locally directly. Okay, this is the value brought by our layer 3 to the edge. Another point is that the networking will be very flexible facing some new business scenarios. It can also better cope. Another point is slicing, right? We just mentioned on the core network side, we extract the original core network, the function of the network element into different functions or different services, and then achieved through this kind of scheduling and orchestration in the bearer network or in the transmission side or in the backhaul network. We implement network slicing through FlexE-Eth, or to achieve transmission network slicing, the concept of FlexE-Eth. It might be relatively clear here. We actually split a physical port, right? Split a physical port into different ones. For example, this physical port is 40G. I split it into 10G, 20G. How did I achieve it? In fact, it is through TDM time division multiplexing to achieve. So it's a hard isolation, right? This time division multiplexing method. In our early SDH network, that is in the TDM, SDH network. In fact, we use TDM, right? This time division multiplexing, then it's a hard pipe, right? We give a certain site, a certain network member assigned 2E1s, right? Then I only gave you 4M, right? This is a hard isolation. Other network elements cannot occupy your 4M, right? Then we actually talk about IP later. Talking about IP emphasizes more of a sharing concept, right? We no longer emphasize hard pipes. Then in the early SDH, in fact, it is a TDM-based time division system. Right? It's a hard pipe. But later we emphasized IP. What we emphasize more is the concept. the concept is sharing. But now if we want to go back to this flex state, in fact, the core of FlexE-Eth's implementation. In fact, it is achieved through TDM because you need to ensure the isolation of different slices on the transmission network. We also need to ensure a strong isolation. We can consider it as hard isolation, but can we call it absolute isolation? This concept may be a bit absolute, but we will call it hard isolation. We split a 40G port into a 10G, one is 20G, and another 10G. In this way, these three interfaces, we divide these three bandwidths, 10G, 20G, 10G, we can adapt it to distribute to different slices for use. So this is our concept of flexible Ethernet basic concept. Then in this way, split a port into this, a physical port, split into three logical ports. For each port, we allocate a certain bandwidth. For example, this is 10, this is 20, this is 10. And then at this time, they are between each other. They are isolated from each other. For example, this is a slice, slice 1. It occupies 10G slice 2. It occupies 20G slice 3. It occupies 10G, but I take slice 2 defined as for URLLC business scenarios. For example, it is for vehicular networking, but I can be what? Inside this slice, I might sell this slice to Mercedes at the same time, sold to BMW, sold to Toyota. Inside this slice, they can still share. This is based on our application. Such a network, transmission networks, hard slicing, it is through such a FlexE-Eth technology to achieve. Of course, through this kind of hard pipe segmentation, to achieve this kind of different force or different applications, isolation between different slices inside the slice, we can use soft pipes to achieve this kind of user level distinction between slices is hard isolation. Inside the slice, we can use this kind of soft pipe. To achieve such a business distinction, this is our data forwarding gate. Of course, we will have some control plane functions. Of course, the control plane functions we will implement through NC. Such a network cloud engine, this is our transmission side or our bearer network side. A new device to achieve such functions through it. Of course, there will be some such management plane functions for control and management. We will implement through the upper layer such applications. This is our transmission part of the slice. Through this FlexE-Eth or FlexE-Eth technology applied in our transmission network, inside the bearer network, core network slicing we just introduced, finally, we will take a look wireless part of the slice.